I think with the kind of demonstrations and we've had now that we have an opportunity to revitalize a new generation. My full name is Pamela Mays McDonald, but you can call me Pam. I've been an Oakland resident for about 30 years. I have two young adult children who I've raised in the public and private schools here. I'm an accidental politician. I was never interested in leadership, but people kept asking me to take it. And my friends started coming out of the woodwork. Yeah, we want you to do that. They started sending me money. They sent me money to go to the inauguration of President Obama. They've been sending me money to go to convention. And what they keep telling me is, we want you to represent us. We need you. And the majority of those people are creative individuals, people who are involved in the creative arts or culture or restaurants or design or all of those fields that have completely revolutionized our economy here in the East Bay and improve our neighborhoods. And also give our young people something to hold on to. For many years, I was a museum director, an art museum director in San Francisco and at the Smithsonian in Washington. And I thought it was very important because I do believe that cultural arts is really the glue that binds us together. It's not what separates us, it's what brings people together. And it creates community. So that's been my career. I'm running again because Black Lives Matter. I'm running because Brown Lives Matter. I'm running because young lives matter. Because teachers' lives matter. Because students' lives matter. Because the arts matter. Because affordable housing in the Bay Area matters. And because of those things, that's what wakes me up in the morning, that's what fires me up, are those protecting those people who I'm afraid are very vulnerable here in the Bay Area and the economy. And I also believe that they need their equal rights. Women and girls' lives matter. And I, as a Democrat and a delegate in the state of California, I've been a delegate for 2 years now. I'm the only delegate who has been raising the important issues that are so important to people here in my 15th Assembly District and also in the 18th. What I need to do is to help the other delegates across California to help strengthen them and help them feel strong enough that they can stand up for these issues in their community. So I think people in the East Bay here in Berkeley and the whole region here of 8015, we're national leaders and we have to show leadership. That's what I've been doing. And people here are demonstrating still every single day. The Trayvon Martin resolution was unanimously passed across the state. I presented it at many caucuses. Women's Caucus was one that supported it. Latino Chicano Caucus, Children's Caucus, African American Caucus, Native American Caucus. These people understand what happened and what we need to do to protect our young people. And so they supported it. So after the resolution was passed by all these caucuses and all these levels, then I went the next step, which is to have language from the resolution put into the party platform, which means that anyone who wants to be a candidate for office and wants the Democratic Party support, or any elected official who claims they're a Democrat, has to abide by the issues in the platform. So my Trayvon Martin resolution called for a complete ban on stand your ground and stop and frisk. And I'm pleased to say that it's not just been accepted by thousands of Democrats in a voting process throughout the state, but now it's a part of the party platform that anyone who runs for office has a copy of this that they've got to resist stop and frisk or stand your ground from coming here in the entire state. So the Ferguson resolution is a little bit different. When I saw what happened to the people in Ferguson, Missouri, and the first news that came out was that the majority of 99% of their police officers were not African American, even though 70% of the population in Ferguson is African American. When I learned that their school board, 6 of the 7 members are not African American, when I learned that their city council, there was only one person that was African American, in a city that is 70% African American, and I found out that only 6% of the eligible black voters in Ferguson voted in the last election. So you kind of get what you put into it. But then you look at their history, centuries of slavery, Reconstruction, where people were lynched and hung from trees for the crime of trying to register to vote or trying to start a business or talking back. And then after that, the years of segregation, when everything was not even separate but equal, it was just plain separate and it was unequal. And all these years of discouraging them and, you know, all the voter suppression efforts that have been done to them, I'm an activist and I started seeing solutions right away. And one of them was to set a goal of 100% participation in voting and to support the people in Ferguson and their struggle, but also to look at places in California. Turns out we've got places in Central California particularly and neighborhoods right here in Oakland and Berkeley where only 5% of the people are voting. Why is that? And what are we doing to reach out to those people? Why are people feeling like they have no power? Why are they disenfranchised? And so my Ferguson resolution addresses that we need to take responsibility here in California to look for those low turnout areas. We've got to re-enfranchise our people. They are citizens. Why are they not using their power? So I have to take the resolution and then do the next step, which is to take language from it and put it into the party platform, so that if anyone wants to run for office in 2016 in the state of California, they've received copies of it, and they understand that their job is to fight all efforts to disenfranchise any voters anywhere across the state. And that their goal, no matter what county they're from, they need to be reaching out to those other counties and helping to register people there and helping to get 100% participation in the democratic process, regardless of what your party is or where you live. I'm leading something that will help people all over the country and in these counties of California where they just feel like they can't even go vote, and all of their legal representatives, all their political representatives, do not represent them, as happened in Ferguson. Since that time, we've had what happened to Eric Garner. And we need to look into banning the chokehold. And we can do that in California. So I'm hoping that if I'm reelected, somehow I can get an appointment, because I realize that if I'm not there, it's not going to happen. The party platform changes again in 16. This is my birthright. As a young girl, I lived in Little Rock, Arkansas, while my parents were in school. And my very first memory in life at the age of 2 was the riots that took place when those students tried to enter the school. And it's amazing, as a 2-year-old, it took me until an adult to recognize my memory. And I remember the fear in my mother's face. My real interest right now, I'm watching these young people that are out there now that are so excited and so fired up right now. And I want to represent them. I've got a 28-year-old and a 22-year-old, and I want to be that force that makes the Democratic Party something that they feel that they can join in and not feel that they're alienated. It's for old folks, and oh, they're just the same as the Republicans. And I think with the kind of demonstrations that we've had now, that both of my children in New York and in Los Angeles are involved in, I think we have an opportunity to revitalize a new generation.